Welcome back. We are going to be gassing and oiling up the 550 XP Mark II with the muffler mod, and we're going to get some wood cut up. I'm out of wood to split. The whole pile is stacked, and there's three face cords or one full cord. I love this stuff. Happy juice. Ooh, she's squirting. Dirty girl. That's a little loose. I paint all my bar wrenches orange just so I can find them easier. Paint peels off fairly quickly. I like these Oregon bars, they're pretty good. Now today we're going to focus on small tree felling. I am no expert at this, I don't have much experience in it at all. But I've watched a couple things, so we'll see how it goes. Thank you. crisp 23 degrees outside today. There we go.
Thank you.
Last guy that commented on my video about the 562 with the rakers, he was right. This is a newer chain and this cuts way faster. I'm not sure if it's just the type of chain I'm using or what, but I don't know. This saw almost outcompetes the 562 in some aspects of power to weight. Alright, so we got 1, 2, 3 down. Let's do this next. Let's get some confidence. Let's put it right on top of that one. Got some back lean to it, which is concerning. Might just leave that one alone. Now, I just need a little more help. This one can go though. Yeah.
Okay.
decent amount done today. A couple little little guys, little ash trees that aren't gonna have a home anyway, because that ash borer is eating through everything anyway. So if they don't have it yet, they're gonna soon. Mainly just doing firewood production. This is just to get out of the way, to get these bigger ones out that are surrounding me here. A lot of these other ones are pretty tall, so mainly using these small rounds as a base to put the bigger ones on, because you see that ground, you just sink right into it when you stand on it. I do want to get that other big one back there just trimmed up, but this chain is done for today. I'm gonna go grab another chain and see if we can get some more stuff done, but for now this chain is the drivers are all busted on it. I'm gonna have to flat file them down to get them to sit in the groove evenly again. I need to get my pole saw out so I can stand up and do most of this without having to hold a big saw. That'd be nice. But yeah, the Husqvarna 550 XP Mark II, highly recommended. Great little 50cc chainsaw. Power to weight is very, very good. It rips through most things that you put up to it, even the bigger stuff. Muffler mod it, give it some more airflow. Pretty much undo what the EPA did to it in the exhaust to restrict it. Just like you guys do with your diesel trucks and stuff like that when you guys delete EGRs and stuff and make them roll coal. Just make them flow better, runs better, sounds better. You know, not really hoping to gain 5-6 horsepower. It's not really feasible. Maybe a 0.4, 0.5 horsepower, possible, you know. But you're not going to see a whole jump in power because you did a muffler mod. But if you got port work done and a muffler mod, yeah, you know, you might. All right, let's get a new chain on this saw, and then let's get back to it. Because there's wood that needs to be cut up. I'm running low on my supply of firewood. You can never have enough. So figure down these ones. I want to cut some of that big one up first, and all the small branches just put in a big pile and burn. But of course, the sooner now that they're cut up like that, the faster they dry out. This all needs to be burned too, but it's like, unless you take down these little small stragglers, you're gonna have half the woods on fire. So that pile over there is stuff that just has to get cut up to size, but that's all good candidate. And then you have the 7 or 8 rounds that are just massive that will probably not get taken care of unless I can split them easier or have a gas splitter, because these are pretty much petrified. Yeah, I got that pile there of small stuff, and then a pile here of smaller stuff that can be cut up, but other than that, there's not a whole lot of wood left. I'm piecing through this, but I really gotta get this rolled out of that crevice. That should probably be the next thing that I focus on, but that pile there can pretty much go up and start to get split. Just gotta start doing some rounds. Maybe that's what I'll do. Put the saw down for a bit and start getting some splitting done. Just keep the chaps on for warmth. Because all that right there can come up. It's not all seasoned yet, but actually, no, that came off a tree that was cut down recently, so that really can't be brought up. I could bring up the other rest of this black locust. Everything I cut mainly has to stay in the ground until it can dry. See how bad this is. work table's filled with fucking junk. What's going on here? It's like one driver just giving issues. See if we can just fix this chain and not have to. Nope, I think it's gonna be get this chain's done. I think the chain bent. This chain is bent. That's a first. I've never seen a chain bend like this. Like, there's dirt and cake in it, so I'm wondering if it just binded? I don't know, I'll just take it off, put it in. Doing, Moo-moo. Moo's the barn cat. Takes care of all the mice. Alright. I'll just clean these gloves too. That's how it goes. So weird. That's gross. It's all locked up. And bent. If anyone's ever seen this happen, post in the comments, please. This is so weird. That is something else. It's just not flat anymore. That's crazy. This was a semi-chisel. Let's grab the same. Also, might as well clean this off while I have all this out. Show you guys my new shop setup. If I can get the bond chain back on. I'm just putting this on so I don't have to carry three things. I'm just gonna carry one thing. Alright. Clean this off. Get a new chain. Get back at it. Sound of me whacking my head. All right, spin this off. Cool. All right. this off. Crank it up to 80. For now.
Some more air.
Alright, so this is the new compressor setup. I took off the factory regulator off this 21 gallon central pneumatic, 125 PSI air compressor. The knob was really hard to turn, just didn't like it. You couldn't take it apart and grease it or service it, so I just removed it. Put an on-off valve here, so I can shut off tank pressure. Goes to a mini water trap oil separator, to a high flow fitting, to another filter with a regulator that regulates the tank pressure. So now tank pressure is regulated from here. Second moisture trap, larger trap, feeds directly to a 11 gallon or sorry a 7 gallon cobalt air pig. Just an auxiliary tank goes through that and then goes to my 50 foot of line. I have 100 foot flexilla hose on the way. Also have high flow fittings for that. All the blue fittings are high flow and they're quick connects as well. Which is very nice. You don't have to pull the collar down to insert it. And I have another 11 gallon air pig or tank, reservoir tank on the way. I'm going to put in line. A lot of people tee them off. I think in line is the way to go. I have it go through all the tanks and then through the hose. So that's what we're going to do with that. This we can shut off. This reg's turned off. So there's always the same pressure in this tank as in this tank. And so will be the other tank, because we're going to put that in between this and this. So this is going to have the regulator on it and the check valve downstream of this. So that's going to be the way that's going to be set up. I think we're just going to call it for today. It's a beautiful day, but I just cleaned up my saw and everything. I don't really want to go get it dirty again. I'd rather just call it a day, scrap that chain, and throw a new one on it, and come back out another day where I can get some more stuff done. I got a lot of the down stuff down that I wanted to, so. Go box this back up. Go inside, put a chain on her. Garbage. It's just got gas in it. Some cherry logs that I gotta process. Make some nice bundles out of that, and that'll be more expensive stuff. I don't know why I'm putting that there. I already have a spot for it. Chain is done. Next time I buy one from Amazon, that one can go back, because that's no longer flat. You staying warm, kitty? Huh? Staying warm under the heat lamp? Haven't had to use the ST227P yet, only once this year. So winter's been very mild. Put this tool back. keep a scrunch in here. I always keep a scrunch on me and my chaps. So let's see what we got here for wood. Face cord here, face cord in the center, and then a face cord on the other side. I like this method of just covering the top and then letting the sides kind of free flow and hang. This gives the opportunity for it to fill the air but not get saturated. Only like the first couple, 2 or 3 inches are exposed. I'm hoping the black tarp will give it heat and the sun will pretty much dry it out faster, but it's already less than 20%. Most of it's 8-10% ready to be burned. You can see one, two, and then there's three there. So it's poking out. So I gotta get some better mounting on this, I don't know. Kind of come up with something better than just this brace, because this isn't going to hold forever. All the weight is on this end because it's downhill. So this is my throwing platform. This is pretty much where I just throw the logs after they're split, and they pretty much just go into a huge pile, which usually as wide as these two pallets until it's almost as tall as the pallets, and then they just start stacking it in place. But yeah, that was a pretty cool machine that just went by. That's an old schoolhouse, actually. Probably some really cool stuff in the ground around it. Should go to the metal detector sometime and check it out. Probably find some really cool old stuff. Let's split this piece up. I'm gonna keep this pretty much inside. No point in bringing this out. I'll just throw it on the stack that needs wood. Alright, let's go get some more wood. I'll show you guys live in action how the baby controller works. It's a lot of people don't really, I think, believe me when I say a yard full of wood with a baby stroller. live action. Get me hook, get me baby stroller. You've never used a baby for fire or baby stroller for firewood before, it'll change your life. hot to my face. Oh, you stringy bastard. Come on. Oh, there we go. All right. Really nice hardwoods. Now that's one load on the baby stroller of wood. Could use the wagon wheelbarrow, but it's very unstable, and if I drop it, the whole thing's falling over. This one log might fall off, not a big deal. This has three wheels with some pretty amazing bearings in them. The wheels are fired up to probably 45 psi just to hold the weight. All right, I'm confident with that. Yeah, the more you stack on the front, the more you're gonna lose. A lot of you guys got ATVs and tractors. I don't have those. I got a couple professional chainsaws and electric log splitter and a dream. As you can see, it's Times it doesn't go so well.